they enjoy spending their time with.
Yeah.
And that they can either like grow the interaction that they have with these people to try out something and then promise something, or I guess like in a sense, like I guess like what I'm trying to say is you have to explore in a sense.
Three, two, one. Hello, welcome to the Willieolf Podcasting. I'm your host, Willieolf Leung, and today I'm interviewing with my boy named Joey. So let's ask you some questions.
What's up, man? Thank you for having me.
Yeah, first things first, let's start with like who you are. Say your name, what's your major, and what's your year?
Yeah, so first off, my name is Joey Arias. Mm-hmm. I am a kinesiology major, and This is my fourth year here at Cal State LA.
Damn, fourth year? Wow.
Yeah, I'll be finishing up in spring. Thank you. Thank you.
That's really good, man. So what is the hardest part as a student?
Hardest part as a student?
Yeah.
I think it's definitely the balance. It might sound cliche, but for me it's been being able to have all the parts of my life that I need to feel good and feel able in myself to continue my studying. So that's like sleeping, eating, family time, friends time, me time, and you know, I don't need it all in one day, but if I learned that if I can get it all in the mixture of the week, then I can feel okay of going forward with being a student.
Wow, that's, I'm just like you because, you know, as a senior right now, it's going to be really challenging for me because, you know, I'm preparing to, like, you know, get my internships ready, and as well as my resume, which is, we will go down to it, so... Yeah, I'm kind of excited, but also kind of bit, like, nervous in, like, in the future, so, yeah. And one of the things that I wanted to ask you is, I noticed that you work at the recreation center, right?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, that's a... Are you just a staff, or are you, like, some sort of, like, what is it called? Are you, like, a president of the recreation center, or...?
So, there's no, like, president, really. There's just... staff roles, as you kind of said. We have the floor assistant, we have the membership attendant.
Yeah.
Actually, it's flip-flop. It's the floor attendant and then the membership assistant. There you go.
Wow.
But I've done both. So I've been able to like experience like all the roles that recreation has, and I also work the game room. So,
wow, that's nice. Yeah.
It's given me... kind of like I've been able to be in all the roles, so like people have been able to see me in different roles, so they might think that I'm like a group leader in recreation, but I'm just a normal worker.
Wow, that's and you're full-time, right, or part-time?
You can only be part-time technically working here at the university as students.
And just a quick question is, like, what's your, like, responsibility as, a normal worker?
As a normal worker, it depends on, like, which role you are, but generally, you just have to make sure that we are giving the other students around us that are also able to access the gym, to give them that good experience, whether it's, like, keeping the things clean, helping them use things correctly, helping them in terms of like creating a better environment for them. So if there's like rowdy people, or there's like people not sharing, or if there's people hogging things, or if there's just people that just kind of just need that extra assistance, then yeah. That's what I'm here for. And that's what all the other workers are here for, mm-hmm. is to help you get that experience that you need to exercise, to play, to have fun. Recreation.
Wow, that's really good. Wow. Yeah. I've been to here's a funny question. Has anyone played Call of Duty Black Ops 6 in the games room or not yet?
I don't know about Black Ops 6. I don't think so. But they played the other ones.
Oh, they played the, I think it was Black Ops 2 and Black Ops 3. So
right, I think.
Mm-hmm. Do you actually play any Call of Duty games?
I used to a lot when I was let's say like 14,
yeah,
all the way up till I was like 18.
Mm-hmm.
I was playing that a lot, but like as time, or like as I got more into fighting games,
yeah,
I kind of just play those more now. And even now when I try to go back to a shooter game like Call of Duty,
yeah,
I get tired of it like really quickly. It's just like a preference thing, I guess.
Yeah. I actually missed the You heard the game called Warzone, in Battle
yeah.
Royale.
Yeah, the Battle Royale.
The first Warzone 1, I missed it. I kind of missed that. And now they moved to Warzone 2.0 now. Oh man, I played Modern Warfare 2 back then when it was released like 2 years ago. But then I think I kind of stopped after I think it was season 3.
Mm-hmm.
I actually preferred the Modern Warfare 2019. It was the best one, with the graphics and the gun sound. I like the perks and I like the offerings. They're pretty cool. I actually cosplay as Ghost.
Yeah.
Do you ever cosplay before?
Cosplaying. Honestly, I haven't like done anything like purely like, oh, I'm gonna be this character.
Yeah.
I mean, the only character I've really like been said that I've like imitated is like mm-hmm. Bruce Lee or something,
yeah,
or like
wow.
maybe just like some other like fighting game character, but I'm just pretty much myself.
Wow.
Yeah, I haven't really done any cosplaying. If I would though, I'd probably be like a cool anime character or something.
Yeah. I think you saw me like I cosplay as Virgil.
Yes, I've seen a couple of your posts.
Yeah, and yeah, that was from I went to a anime impulse in Orange mm-hmm. County, mm-hmm. and I went to LA Comic Con. LA Comic Con was my favorite because I met Hayden Christensen. You know Hayden? You know him?
Hayden?
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
The guy who plays Anakin from Star Wars.
Oh, okay. Wow, nice.
Yeah, I shake his hand and then I hug him because you know he's my favorite actor, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You played a good Anakin.
Yeah. I'm gonna cosplay as Anakin. I think he's pretty. I saw on Amazon, and it's kind of cheap. I think it's $30 for the outfit. Yeah.
Good starter costume.
Yeah. And yeah. I think when I was in the game room, I actually plugged my laptop and played some TFT. And got first place.
There you go, man. Yeah. That's what the game room's all about.
Yeah, and then afterwards, I actually played Devil May Cry 5, yeah, and yeah, it was really smooth, yeah. Wow. So, I want to talk about how students can be involved in any activity. So, I'm trying to think about like how can students be involved in any clubs.
If a student wants to be involved in any club, they have to take initiative for themselves and put themselves in front of that club.
Yeah.
And say like, hey, what are you guys all about? And if they can get in contact with someone from that club, mm-hmm. then they should be able to like get some information, and with that information, they can decide whether if they want to continue with that club or not. And if they're looking to be involved, then they should try to at least find people that they either trust or that they either like, in a sense where they enjoy spending their time with.
Yeah.
And that they can either like grow from the interaction that they have with these people.
Yeah.
So that no one's wasting their time, because no one wants to try out something and then promise something, or I guess like, in a sense, like, I guess like what I'm trying to say is, you have to explore, in a sense.
Yeah.
That's really what it's all about. You have to explore, and even though people are going to try out new things,
yeah,
they might try it, and then they might like it at first, and then the more they try it, they might like say, oh, it's not just really doing it for me, or maybe they just don't like it in the beginning. So, honestly, I think that's what it's all about, really.
Yeah.
Just, you have to get out there, explore. Sometimes it might be a dud, but sometimes it might be something really good.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
That's how they can get involved in
it. Yeah, just like my experience, when I was in my freshman year, it was, you know, it was COVID still, even though, like, in 2022, we come back in person, and the hardest part is I didn't join any clubs at all. I just, like, you know, focused on my work, and, yeah, especially with the projects, like, yeah, I had to edit videos for my, I know, so...
Yeah, so I mean, I guess in terms of that, like if people even do, like the explorers out there, the ones that do try out a lot of clubs, or they do try to put themselves in front of people, and they just still don't find it very inviting, or maybe they just don't find it welcoming, or maybe they just don't find it, like, they just don't like the vibe.
Yeah.
And then some people, they just kind of just go back to their work, or like just do their own thing.
Yeah.
It's really up to the student to determine, like, okay, if I'm looking to get involved, but I tried out everything, maybe I can try to build something.
Yeah.
So that's exactly kind of what I was doing with the kinesiology club. I didn't make the kinesiology club, but they allowed me to, like, build experiences around kinesiology. So maybe if it's something that you like,
yeah,
that you know a lot of other students like maybe they just like anime, or maybe they just like gaming, maybe you can make a gaming club, but maybe it's a specific type of game club.
Yeah.
So you can have like tennis club, or like table tennis club, or smash club. Like, that's what you have to do if you're looking to have some type of involvement, but also be like your type of own person where you can work and do things that you want to do.
So what clubs do you join? I know you join kinesiology, and right. What else?
Honestly, that's the only club that I need and I wanted. I haven't really explored as much, but I did take a look around like what we do have to offer. Like every time we have that club rush, you know, there's like all those clubs, and there's a lot of good clubs too, but at the same time too, it kind of goes back to what I said earlier in the beginning, balance. Everything, in terms of time spent here at school, it should like make you grow later, or it should like pay dividends later in life. So with that being said, like you can't just join every club.
Yeah, that's honestly true. Yeah.
Especially if you have limited time, if like you need to balance school with study time and homework time, and then also work, and then commuting, and then feeding yourself, and then all the other things that you need for yourself. If you can squeeze it in, then yes, but if not, then you have to figure out that one or two clubs that you need to really make you grow.
I join clubs, like there's only two that I really like. It's JMAC. It's like we collab each other because we love anime, you know, and video games, whatever. So we have an event today, it's called Friendsgiving, so some of our members brought food, and so our meeting is like somewhere in the library, second floor downstairs, and they have a pie, they probably bring drinks, cookies, what else? I think that's about it, but I will go there after we're done with this.
Yeah.
And then the second club that I like was the Kalai, you know, Kalai? I love that club, it's really fun, bro.
Sounds like you got your two clubs, bro, and you've been growing from it, so that's really good for you, man.
And then, the third club, which I think is like a major club, so it's called Film. Basically, we collab with others that want to become an actors. So, yeah, it hasn't been active really well, but I probably need it because next semester, I'm taking a class called Intermediate Production. So what it means is I had to learn roles, like AD, director, first assistant camera, Gaffer, Sam Aquarius, and so on. So that's why I need this server, because, you know, I had to like find actors. We had to find actors.
Yeah.
On campus. And sometimes off campus too. And yes, and yeah, that's a really challenging part as a film student, is, you know, get prepared for everything I can for next year.
Yeah, man, that's really good of you to be thinking about the future, forward thinking, and being ready for those problems that you're gonna have to deal with.
Yeah.
Because if you just wait until the day comes and then the problems are right in front of you, then
yeah.
You know, you might not be well prepared for it, and
yeah.
You might stress yourself out, and it might not get the way that you might not get the results you want. So
yeah.
That's good of you to be thinking like that.
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. Do you have any professors that you like?
For what do you mean?
Like, do you have like your favorite like professor from like your major
professor.
Classes? Yeah.
Let's see. Yeah, I definitely have a lot of favorites. Some
yeah.
A lot of good teachers.
Yeah. Wow. Here's the funny part. So in the first week of I was in August, we were in a class, and it's with Joseph Gallegos. The cinematography teacher. We all sit like, you know, each other, you know, we make a little circle. Funny part is one guy who has introduced himself, he says like, my favorite game is GTA 5. And then Joseph says, here's a funny part, do you feel guilty when you do random stuff in GTA? Yeah. And
yeah. So is that the question for me? Or like, what do you mean?
Well, like, Ubin's like, you know, he's being funny sometimes because, you know, you do something stupid in Grand Theft Auto 5.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I know. There's definitely times where you can just do whatever you want in games like that.
Mm-hmm. That's really good. Yeah. So, I noticed that you have portfolio I saw on Instagram. And, yeah, tell me about it.
Yeah, I mean, I've done lots of past work, and that's the thing about just being an artist and also kind of being an entrepreneur too, is you have to capture your work,
yeah,
and post it and present it in a way where you want people to understand, or like you want people to just get a good idea of what you do.
Yeah.
So if you can put your best work out there, then people will see that, and then
yeah.
You know, things might happen for you.
Yeah. I got some works from the past, but I just forgot. I probably accidentally deleted it by accident, so it wasn't my freshman year, and it happens, bro.
Yeah, man, I mean, that's part of the learning process.
Yeah. Yeah. So, I want to talk about how, like, your passion in dancing. Tell me about it.
Yeah, man, I love it. I've been dancing for 14 years.
Yeah.
I started when I was a freshman in high school. And I feel like I've been dancing before that, like just kind of like randomly when I would watch music videos. But when I was 14, that's when I took it seriously.
Yeah.
And it kind of just became, I don't want to say like it became my life, but it leaked into everything I do.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not completely all a dancer now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm like a kickboxer now.
Yeah.
I'm a gym person now, like a trainer, and I'm many more things now. But being a dancer at first, like,
yeah,
definitely just helped me thrive. It just helped me connect with my ideas,
mm-hmm,
and my heart, and it just let me be a forward learner. Like, it just,
yeah,
like I just kept putting myself out there, and I just kept doing my thing just because I loved it and I was having fun. And then the whole time I didn't know, I was building value for myself for like the longest time.
Yeah. I haven't danced for a while, but I did it in one of the convention centers out there. Yeah.
How was it?
It was fun, bro. I did a dance at LA Comic Con. I did a dance, and the everyone just recording. I had to find the people who record me. I did a dance, and then I just fall off the floor, and then just stand up. And then
Dude, that's the best part, and
yeah,
I totally vibe with that. Like, people will record you, but like you don't even know them.
Yeah.
Wait, can I get the video?
Yeah. they did it at Anime Expo too. Yeah. And then I went to Anime Pasadena about 3 weeks. We did a dance and it was fun.
That's good.
And the good thing is they post on YouTube, on Instagram too.
That's fun, dude.
Yeah.
That's fun.
Yeah, bro. Yeah.
Dancing.
Mm-hmm. So quick question about your resume. How important is the resume?
It's everything, bro. If you want a job, or if you want anyone's attention, if you want the attention of someone who has the ability to give you money,
yeah,
you want to look the best on paper. Like, yeah, you want to be able for people to like look at a paper and look at 20 other papers and then be like, no, I like this paper the most.
Yeah.
Because it says the right words. It just speaks to this person. It's like, I want this person. I'm going to call this number and I want to talk to this guy.
Yeah.
That's why the resume is like a big part. It's not everything, but it's a really big part.
Yeah.
You got to be clean.
Yeah. I know that also applies to like film students as well. But
everywhere.
Yeah.
Everywhere. It's business.
Yeah, that's honestly true. And how important is portfolio? Or would that say like...
It's definitely... It depends on how you use it. Because you can use your portfolio to advertise yourself.
Yeah.
I would say it's also equally as important, I guess.
Yeah.
I don't want to say it's like more or less important. But you definitely need to have it clean. You want to have your best work shown. And you also want to have it relevant for the person. Like, let's say I'm a dancer, right?
Yeah.
And then I want to go work for a video game company. I'm not going to show... And like, the job that they want is for a coder.
Oh.
I'm not going to show them my dancing skills.
Yeah.
And hope to get that coding job.
Yeah.
They're going to want a coder. They're like, dude, your dancing is cool and all, but like, can you do like logarithmic, algorithmic coding language? I'm like, what is that? They're like, exactly where I like. I can't pay you to do this work. You don't have the skills I need. So that's the thing. You have to make sure your portfolio matches the job or like the field that this person is looking for.
Yeah, wow. Another part that I want to get to know about was I know you have Instagram, right? How did you get 10K followers?
Well, it all started back in the Vine days.
Are you
familiar with the app?
Vine days?
Vine.
Spell it V-I-N-E, right?
Yeah. Vine it was days. The first video sharing app to be on the App Store.
Oh, is it free?
No. It was a long time ago, bro. It was like the 2014 era.
Oh, wow, that's 10 years.
How old were you 10 years ago?
11, yeah.
Did you have a phone back then?
Phone? I don't even remember, but
when did you first get a phone?
I think probably high school.
So before you even had a phone, I was making videos online, dancing videos.
Yeah.
And they were getting a lot of attention because I was like one of the only dancers on there.
Yeah.
And then soon I became like one of Vine's like advertised dancers, or like the ones that they just put on the app first thing you see. So yeah, I pretty much got a lot of followers on Vine, but some of them transferred over to Instagram, or like I was able to get them to go to Instagram by putting my handle in my videos. So like I would make a Vine video and then I would put the watermark.
Yeah.
I would put like, it's Joey Arias. That was my handle back then.
Yeah.
And then like next thing you know, like I'm getting followers in Vine and then I'm also getting followers on Instagram.
Yeah.
But I don't really post on Instagram, but because they've seen it on Vine, they go to Instagram, they type it in, they're like, oh, there he is, and I follow him.
Oh.
So that's how I've actually had 20K, but like, you know, over time, and like I wasn't like creating videos a lot ever since then. So it's just died. It's been dying like ever since. So like it went from like 25K or something like that, all the way down to where it's at, 10K.
Yeah. So it's unavailable right now, right?
Yeah, Vine, it's like a legacy page now. Like, you go on Vine right now, and there's like hardly anything on it, and
it's always shut
works.
Down completely.
Yeah.
Wow. That's kind of sad, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the story.
Yeah. So, since you're graduating next semester, which is like spring, are you pursuing like your master's after, or?
That's a really good question. As of right now, no. I plan on having my own business by then. At least I had planned to have like a couple of basic baseline jobs. It was like training and being a coach at like fitness centers. But ideally, I want to have a business where I can teach people and help people to learn about their body using dance. And that's where kinesiology comes in, and it's gonna help me formulate and like teach people, educate people about their body using my experience from dance, and then using the language of kinesiology to help people just get benefits and increase their health and their bodies and their movement.
Yeah.
That's what I'm all about.
Wow. You like you like that major?
I love my major, man.
Yeah.
Wow. I love my major. I think it's definitely given me what I want.
Yeah.
You know, everyone has their own ideas and stuff, but I'm not closed to the idea of returning to school. It's just like right now, I haven't given it too much thought. I'm just too busy like running my own stuff.
Yeah,
I'm trying.
Yeah, I've thought about like, I want to do like master's, but I think like getting a film degree, that's about it. I only care about that, and I don't want to pursue it. I think it's because, you know, that's all I need, and that's about it.
Yeah. You're a film student, right?
Yes, correct.
And once you get your bachelor's, you get the film degree.
Yes.
And then after that, you just plan to make films and just do film stuff. You don't need to get a master's to feel okay to do film stuff. Like, you're doing film stuff right now.
Yeah, that's true. And even like, I don't even need a PhD as a film.
You don't need a PhD or a master's to have permission to do what you want.
Yeah.
You can do what you want now. Mm-hmm. You don't even have to have this whole schooling degree to do this podcast.
Yeah.
You know, we're just doing it now because that's what we want to do, and we happen to be getting our degree at the same time.
Yeah.
But yeah, you don't, it's not like a requirement thing is all.
Yeah. So, is your major like really hard?
Yeah, it can be challenging. Luckily, I like the stuff.
Yeah.
You know, it has to do with the body. It has to do with the mentality, the psychology.
Yeah.
It has to do with people.
Yeah.
It has to do with the body.
Yeah.
These are all stuff that I love.
Yeah.
And it has to do with movement.
Yeah.
And I love that. So I just might be like the accidental person that is perfect for this major, but in the sense of like enjoying my major, definitely enjoy my major.
Yeah. So like, when it comes up to like, I'm a film major, right? You know, I thought it would be like super easy for me because, you know, we do projects and I never do testing before in my film major, even though there's one and that's about it, but it was up a nose, everything. It's like, you can like, I can even search it online if I have to, in case if I don't have an answer for it. But as soon as like, you know, make projects, whatever, it gets so hard, it gets tough.
Yeah, man, that's where that balance comes in. Mm-hmm. You know, you gotta reallocate time to things that you can really work towards and solve.
Yeah, it's a learning process for me, and we even watched a documentary called Who Needs Sleep. So basically, most filmmakers they work like over like 12 hours. It was 19.
That's the thing about film too, is it's definitely not like your typical normal jobs.
Yeah.
It's something that requires a lot of passion, lots of commitment, and lots of that extra thing. And that's, I feel like that's just anywhere in life that you have passion for, or something that you want to have grow, or that, something that you want to support you. You need to give it that extra detail.
them. Yeah. So, yeah, being a film major, I thought it was like harder than nursing, but it is extremely hard. Yeah, because you know, I had to like make a schedule for me. I had to like know what time I had to get up, and just had to like, you know, beat up the calls. So like, when it's lunch time at 12, we all had to go lunch at 12, and we get like certain minutes. Like, you have to eat for like about 30 minutes, and then you have to go back to work. There could be breaks, but you know, it's pretty challenging for all film majors. It's gonna be hard.
Yeah, is that something that you enjoy?
Yeah, I really enjoy it. Yeah, and that's a good thing. And
there you go.
Yeah, and then afterwards, I'm planning to use a film degree on somewhere else because you know the industries in film, it's really competitive. Yeah, you think all job marketing is competitive?
Definitely. We're in America where things are, you know, it's capitalism. It's competition everywhere. But I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing, and it's something to get bogged down. You can definitely find the gaps where you can fill in and provide value.
Yeah,
I really feel like that it's possible. You just have to keep finding it. You can't get discouraged. The more you run into the wall, or like the more you like trip and fall, and the more you can get up and keep going, the more likely you're gonna find something, and the more likely you're gonna become successful.
Wow, that's So one of the things that I want to talk about is like, we see new students as a freshman, and you know, we see it, they see us like, you know, we're doing the first time broadcasting. So what's your like, your advice to anyone who is like starting college?
For anyone that's going to be starting college?
Yes.
It's crazy because I was once like the ones that just came fresh out of high school.
Yeah.
And I was not interested in school, but I was still doing it because it's just what everyone else was doing.
Yeah.
The parents wanted me to do it, so I can definitely vibe with those students that kind of just are here because they are forced to, for lack of a better word.
Yeah.
But to continue on the train of, you know, being ready for school, like, what can you do? You have to either, I would either say, explore what you want, really be honest with yourself. You have to be like, okay, this is what I'm really interested in. Let me go do some of those things. So I would say you have to go expose yourself to this subject.
Yeah.
Don't be like me and be like, oh, I want to be an economics major and never do an economics class.
Yeah.
And then when I do the economics class, I'm like, oh my God, I don't like this.
Yeah.
And I try to trick myself into liking it because it's what I picked.
Mm-hmm.
But then I just end up making myself more miserable.
Wow. Yeah. Yeah, I seen some of my friends, they picked that major, but all of a sudden they switched major, which is totally okay. It happens. Yeah. But I think one of the problems is you have to start from like the beginning. Yeah, and in the GEs, I don't think it doesn't count because you know that's for the credit. But if you're taking classes that are like major classes, then it won't transfer to your credit.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, that's.
Yeah, so like with that being said, that's the thing, you won't know what you really want until you keep trying to, and you might not even like what you thought you liked, and now you're halfway in, or even like all the way almost done, and you still like, maybe you don't like it. You have to still lean on your skills. You have to lean about like, okay, maybe I don't like the degree, but what skills am I getting out of this area?
Yeah.
So if you're not dead set on like, oh, I love being a film major, but maybe you can still be a film major and practice your communication skills, your filming skills, your distribution skills, all these other skills that you're gonna need to make money later in life.
I was about to change my major as a film major, so that was happening my first year, but I decided to stay where I was. So like, because you know, like I said from the beginning, it was so I unfortunately had to say like it won't transfer to everything. So I kind of wish the film major is like a minor to me. Mm. So yeah, I want to do computer science, but I think it's a bit challenging because, you know, you have to get good with math. And I think that also includes accounting too. You have to like get good at math whatsoever.
Mm. Yeah, you have to do things that are uncomfortable in school. And you have to lean on your resources.
Yeah.
You have to go get tutoring. You have to be honest with yourself and you have to say, hey, I'm not getting it. Teacher, I don't understand. Or, hey, classmate, like, I'm not getting it. Do you get it? You have to figure out, you know, it does become who you know at that point.
Yeah.
And you have to not be discouraged. You have to put your pride aside, yeah, your ego aside, and you have to be like, hey, man. Like,
yeah. Wow. Yeah. I actually did my first tutoring and it was pretty helpful. And I think it was two times in a row, one for my media writing and one for my TV history programming. And it really helped me out, especially with writing. I'm kind of stuck at writing, so it really helped me out a lot. Wow. Yeah. So what's your advice to anyone who are like, you know, just, you know, have fun in college, you know?
My advice to anyone who might be watching this or maybe is like a first time student,
yeah,
is definitely explore,
yeah,
and be comfortable with rejection or like getting slapped in the face, not in the like physical sense, but yeah, in the sense where it's like, hey, you're wrong, or like, hey, that can be better, or like, hey, what are you doing? Like, you know, we're in school and that's what it's all about. It's about being challenged, it's about being uncomfortable, and the more you can be comfortable with being uncomfortable, mm-hmm, the more you'll be like, oh, like, this is all on purpose, this is all, yeah, for me to grow, and this is all for me to become a more realized version, or a more refined version of myself within the next 4 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sometimes even five.
Yeah.
Or even six.
Yeah,
and even more.
Yeah, it can come back. It can go to like a. It can go back to this thing where it's like you're a student in, yeah, life,
yeah,
where you're always learning, but in the sense where we are like investing money and like pulling out loans to go to school,
yeah,
and you know using the system here in America, mm-hmm, to get our education, however we can get it,
yeah,
is what we need to do, and what we need to be ready for,
yeah,
is to flip it, or wow, is to use these skills to earn money later in life. So the more you can be okay with being uncomfortable and being knowing that everything here is to help me grow, and then be comfortable in the stuff that you're getting here to grow with, so that once you are about to graduate or once you, yeah, do graduate, you can be like, boom, I know how to make money, I know how to earn enough, I know how to survive, I know how to think.
Yeah.
That's really,
yeah,
all it is. How to think.
Yeah. Yeah, and just so like to the audience out there, please be careful out there, you know, try not to procrastinate, especially with like GEs, because those GEs are like a gamble. They're really hard.
Yeah, like if you're constantly putting yourself in a procrastination state,
yeah,
you know, you have to come to terms with that you can have influence in your life by just doing a couple of small changes here and there. Mm-hmm. It's going to be uncomfortable, but once you do it a lot, you get the muscle, and then the next thing you know, you're able to do things effortlessly, and
yeah,
you're able to take care of yourself, you're able to take care of problems, and then next thing you know, you're like this person who everyone is like looking up to, and they're like, yo, you, like, you help me with my problems. Like, I want to go to you now. Or like,
yeah,
I look at this person's resume and they are like just everything I want, because
yeah,
they know how to think.
Wow. Yeah. So one last advice that I want to ask you is, what is like your advice to anyone who is like graduating or just be prepared for entering the real world?
Man, I couldn't be the one giving advice because,
yeah,
I don't know, I've never graduated.
It's all right, man.
Before.
Yeah.
But personally, just kind of having the future in sense, or like in mind. You know, we want to be ready to take on these problems, to organize ourselves, so we can handle anything that life throws at us, so we can be ready to adapt, survive, but also thrive. If we can do it, all those basics really well, then we can have loving relationships, we can have a balanced life, we can have everything that life has to offer, not just work and earning money. It can be all the things like family, community, love, spirituality, hobbies, interests, you know, curiosities, you know, like life is just so much more than working and earning money.
Correct.
But if we can use the time that we are investing here in school to become this better version of ourselves, then we won't feel like school is a scam, or we won't feel like, oh, I just did 4 years of this boring work and I wasn't challenging myself, but I was just barely scraping by. Then now I'm in all this debt, and now I have to go do basic stuff because my skills aren't up to date, and now I'm working minimum wage for the rest of my life. Like, I don't want to like say it like that, but it'll definitely become up to the person what they can do once you graduate, and once the training wheels are off, as I like to say it. It's really up to you, but hopefully with all the being around all these good people and all these education, you know, that's not the case.
So yeah, and I want to talk to you honest real quick. My advice to like anyone who's like about to graduate, just be ready for everything and anything at all in the real world.
You know, something really that like made me think of is just have a system. And a way you can be ready is to just have a system. If you know that every day you need to do this at work, or you need to provide something at this moment, or you need to just create something, build a system for it. Write yourself a schedule and then do this system, and then if the system worked, then you don't have to think about, oh, I need to make this happen. Like, oh no, I know how to make it happen. That's it.
Wow. That's a really good advice. So we want to end this show right here. So to the audience who like wants to like connect with you or just follow with you, how can we find you?
If anyone wants to connect with me or follow me, find me, you can look up at the Jozen, T-H-E-J-O-Z-E-N. That's my Instagram. And if you want to visit my website, it's it's www.ce. Oh my gosh, I cannot spell it right now.
It's all right, man.
It's Q. Oh my gosh. It's Q by Jozen, but you spell Q like C-U-E-D. It's kind of a tongue twister now that I'm like starting to think about it right now. But it's Q by Jozen.com.
Okay, got it, got it. Yeah. And oh, one more thing. Students or audience, whatever, please take the advantages of like getting the resources in college. That's the most important thing. I almost forgot about that.
Yeah, that's a big tip right there.
Yeah, try like, you know, go to the events, you know, make friends, and also make sure to join clubs in your freshman year ASAP, because you're gonna be feel bored when you're
Yeah, I totally agree.
All right, man.
Thanks, Willie.
Yeah, thanks, man. Just gonna give a like quick little shout out. Shout out to my boy Joey. Thanks for, you know, having an interview. But also shout out to my professor Julian Reyes, and to the whole class out there in podcasting. And then I also appreciate the time to like, you know, I'm gonna give my shout out to the ASI for giving me this room, because you know, I ask and I reserve it, and we take it and we take the dub.
Yeah, man. Very good use of your resources.
Yeah, see? It's so, we take the W right there, man.
Good job, man.
Yeah.
Thanks for sending me down.
And then, handshake. Oh. Yeah, man. And then, clap. 1, 2, 3. Yeah.
All right, man. That's it. Thank you.